Justice League 2, hey? There's some Justice League 2 news. Interesting, but it's not what you're thinking. So, yo, what is good, YouTube? What's you here? If you're new around here, make sure to subscribe to never miss any of the videos. Check us out on Instagram at Wustu if you want to see the face behind the voice. Also, check us out on Twitter, Wustu G, aka Wustu. So, Charles Roven, Justice League producer, has been talking to a Hollywood trade about Justice League 2, and it's in development, apparently. So, the headline is Justice League 2 producer thinks sequel will come in a number of years. Justice League 2 might be a few years away, says producer Charles Roven. Justice League was released in 2017. No, it wasn't. That was a Sweden cut. It was released in March 2021. Justice League 2 was originally announced June the 14th, 2019, but Warner Bros. Chose to focus on the Justice League being one film. And that was the downfall. No, it wasn't the downfall. We all know the downfall. The downfall is they didn't let Zack Snyder go through with a plan that was freaking epic. It's critically acclaimed. All the critics said Zack Snyder's Justice League was better than Warner Bros. Justice League. Let's just call it that. So the plan was kind of destroyed from the inside, to be honest, with everyone getting involved. But it is an interesting piece. Of course, it will be years away for many reasons. The Suicide Squad movie came out. The Flashpoint movie is essentially going to not reboot everything like everyone says, because Gal Gadot is still going to be Wonder Woman. Aquaman is still going to be Aquaman. Ezra Miller is still going to be The Flash. But what it is going to do is it's going to open the multiverse. Yes, I know the Snyder movie. I know Zack Snyder's Justice League literally showed the multiverse and spoke about the multiverse. But essentially, nothing can go forward in the DCEU Walter Hamada-verse. That isn't a criticism. That's literally what I've got to call it to make you understand what I'm on about. Nothing can go forward, realistically, until the Flash movie comes out. So it appears a lot of factors may give Warner Bros. Some pause about Justice League 2. Justice League producer Charles recently told THR he would want to return for a follow-up, following up the Suicide Squad as well as Justice League sequel. He did indicate, however, this would be years away, though he didn't say exactly how long. It has already been 4 years since the theatrical release, because in Warner Brothers Studios' eyes, the theatrical release is canon. It's freaking canon. Like, it's at, you know, with the mustache Superman on the mobile phone, that is canon. So this is what he actually said, but still have affiliation with some more Suicide Squad, which I'm thrilled about. I hope James will, when he gets some time, come back and see if he's going to do another one, because like, he did such an amazing job, and he did. Thank you very much, Warner Bros. UK, for letting me see the Suicide Squad movie early, inviting me to the UK premiere. It was a freaking cool event. Very good movie. In fact, I think it's one of the best DC movies ever. Not saying it's the best, but it's one of the best. I would definitely be a part of that. Probably another Justice League, although I think that's a number of years away. Now, we're going to have to say it's in the works in the title, because he wouldn't be saying this. But when he throws words around, like, although I think it's a number of years away, there's no actual confirmation anywhere in this interview that it's concurrently being worked on. In the next few years, DCU will expand with more heroes. Wonder Woman, Aquaman, The Flash, etc. Batgirl, Zendaya, Black Adam, Shazam, Wustu. I'm just saying Wustu to see if you guys are still here. So it is interesting that this is confirmation in a roundabout way that there is going to be a Justice League 2, but the Justice League 2 they're referring to wouldn't be the Zack Snyder's Justice League team. It would be a completely different team, different vibe, or will it? We don't know. Because it's all right people saying all this information now is the Discovery merger. Whatever happens with said Discovery merger, if David Zaslav comes in, is like, yo, Zach, let's work together. Let's get rid of Toby Emmerich, restore the Snyderverse, do Justice League 2, 3, Batflex series, bam, bam, bam. Then there wouldn't be a new Justice League. But realistically, guys, the multiverse will be introduced in the Flash movie. So there could be multiple Justice Leagues in theory, if that's the way that they wanted to go down, which I find very interesting. And also, I think this Justice League piece will actually trigger a lot of fans, because a lot of fans do want to see, yo, Darkseid said, let's do it the old way. Get the Armada ready. Superman post-credit scene. scene. What happened? Everyone wants to know, because the original storyboards for Justice League 2 and 3, that's not the real ones now. Zach has changed them completely, and then you got people going off at him because Lois is having a baby with Bruce Wayne, which never actually happened, and then my name's getting thrown into conversation with people that are irrelevant, people like calling me out and saying things I don't even say, and I'm like, yo, what are these people even on about? Why am I even addressing this? Because, yeah, people think the fact that Lois Lane was going to have a baby with Bruce Wayne was ridiculous, although I didn't agree with it. Zach has literally said that is not what he is planning, and what's on the storyboards, that is already finished. So I do find this very interesting, because although it's an opinion piece with a trade, it doesn't really say a lot. It really doesn't say a lot. Snyderverse saying in an interview earlier this year that Warner Bros. Has no interest in working with Zack Snyder to direct Justice League 2. I think Snyder does have an interest, and there has definitely been conversations behind the scenes, but the latest I heard was Toby Emmerich kind of put everything on hold for some reason. And like I keep saying, guys, have faith in the Discovery merger. It will happen. It's just going to take some time. But at the same time, guys, it's not going to be the case that the Discovery merger happens, then literally the Snyderverse gets restored instantly. And some people seem to think that the Zack Snyder Justice League 2 and 3 are going to be revealed at DC Fandome event this year. I can't really see that happening, although some people seem to think that Henry Cavill Man of Steel 2 is getting announced there. Well, if that does happen, I will be surprised. Although I have been told some things about Henry Cavill coming back as Superman, but not on that level. Like I keep saying, guys, now there's a merger in play. They can't really greenlight any projects at the moment, although these little fluff HBO Max things, them. But have you noticed how they haven't announced any new movies or anything like that? It's just HBO, 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 because they're trying to get everything on HBO before Discovery comes in and cleans house and potentially gets rid of Ann Sernoff, Walter. I think Walter Hamada, to be fair, is probably one of the few people who will be safe from the slate. Toby Emmerich's contract is going to be up soon anyway, and the fact that he was trying to get a job at Netflix tells you he was on the chopping board anyway. So I thought I'd cover this because it is relevant, and a Justice League producer says Justice League 2 is in the works, but of course it's in the works. Justice League should have broke $1 billion. But if Black Widow is anything to go by, I think it's going to be a very long time before any movie hits $1 billion again. And literally every movie coming out theatrically is flopping, mainly due to streaming services. But what I find really interesting, really funny, is Godzilla vs. Kong literally killed Jungle Groot. Godzilla vs. Kong killed a lot of the movies coming out now. And you've got to understand, when Godzilla vs. Kong came out of the cinema, it wasn't even out in Europe at all, because the cinemas were closed. So it's a very interesting time for cinema as a whole. But yeah, there will be another Justice League team for sure. But if Ezra Miller's in it, if Gal Gadot's in it, if Jason's in it, is it still Zack's Justice League? Kind of, probably not, but he hired him, so it will still always be part of the DCEU Zack Snyder continuity, regardless to what they do in the multiverse. As Andy Muschietti says in his movie, everything that's ever happened in DC still happens and still would have happened post-Flash movie. So realistically, the Snyderverse can never die, because it's always going to be there because of the heritage, the history, and the multiverse. So like always, guys, let me know, what do you think about this? It's not breaking news, but it's a slow day and there realistically isn't much to talk about, and you guys love Justice League and so do I, but at the moment there's no actual information about Justice League 2, the Batflex series, and all that kind of good stuff. So like always, guys, check us out on Instagram at WarStew, check us on Twitter WarStewG, and if you want to work with me or any brands want to work with me, just hit me up on business email, wushubusiness@gmail.com, and I will catch you in another video very soon, guys. Catch you later.